So the code that the attacker wants to craft is basically is code that is going to launch this command shell that we're talking about. And that kind of code is called shell code. So how do you write shell code? Where some little bit of expertise comes in. So the shell code, as I said, creates a shell, which is going to allow you to execute arbitrary commands. So any code program that we have, the attacker can ask that that particular code be executed. So let's talk a little bit about how do you craft the shell code. So a call you're making to launch a shell. You can write that code in C, for example. It's a fairly short piece of code. You're just using one of the calls. And then let's say you compile it into assembler instructions. So once you have the assembly instructions, remember the shell code has to be machine code because these are values and then they have to be encoded properly and things like that. These are values that you're going to store in memory. That's where your shell code is. That's where control is going to be transferred. So memory is going to store these binary values. So you have to essentially, may look like data, but actually, you know, it is really represents instructions or opcodes. And if your program is instructed to go execute from there, then it is going to be a program. So you really have to figure out what the instructions are and what data those instructions are going to use when they execute. And you're going to craft that as a set of values that you load into this part of memory. And that's going to be based on either instruction opcodes or the machine code, as I said before. But the way you can do that is by writing the code in a high-level language assembler, translating that to machine code. And that's how you figure out what is the shell code that you're going to need. So it shell code that we're going to place somewhere in memory, this is how you're going to get to it. Then I say we know how to transfer control to it because could modify the return address when the function ended. It'll actually go to this place where the shell code is.